Hi, this is Tom from Freedom Fellowship in Tontitown, Arkansas. I just want to spend just about 3 minutes with you tonight. See, we're in the middle of Holy Week right now, and Holy Week, what a picture of emotions that happens during that week. You know, early in the week in Holy Week, things are great. We have people, Jesus is riding in on the back of a donkey and people waving palm branches. And then later in the week, then all of a sudden, things start to not be as good. We start seeing the arrest, the trial, all the things that happen. But then that hope had faded to hopelessness for his disciples at that time, wondering what was going to happen to them, what was going to happen to all the work that they had put in. But then hope was renewed and evidenced by the very fact of the resurrection of Jesus. It may be that you personally are in one of those spots. You may be in a spot that you're very hopeful, that you and Jesus' relationship is great and things are going well and your family's doing well and prospering. But you may also be in a place where hope isn't there, that your hope has faded. I want to encourage you to attend Easter services. We'd love for you to be here at Freedom Fellowship with us at 10 o'clock on Sunday morning. But if not, I hope you'll find a Bible-believing church and get involved in that church body and be there to be a part of worship. See, hope, the hope that Jesus offers us, that of course will be our focus on Sunday, is the hope that Jesus offers us. In my message, one of the things that just has come back to me this week, but in the message I'll present, it says, it's this: we have to fight for our faith. We have to fight for our family. We have to fight for our church. Because I can guarantee you one thing, the enemy is sure fighting for those same things. It's time that we're not passive anymore. We need to figure out how to get up and pursue Jesus, pursue our faith every day, and not be passive about the things in our faith. So come and join us. If you can't do that, I just hope that you'll catch us on Facebook or YouTube. We'd love to see you here. Our protocols here at Freedom this Sunday, Easter Sunday, they're going to be a little different than what they have been. So we want you to be well informed. What's going to happen is we're going to still ask you to wear your mask as you come into the service and into the building and find your seat. Once you're at your seat, you'll have the prerogative to either continue to wear your mask or to remove it. But one thing we will ask you, if you do leave your seat, whether it's to exit the building at the end of the service or perhaps you need to be up to do something, we'd ask you that you put that mask back on. But while you're at your seat, you have the prerogative to go ahead and leave it on or to remove it for the balance of the service. The chairs we have arranged are such that it allows us by family unit to be seated and be safe and to be socially distanced. That's an important thing, and we want you to know that they've done that in order to keep you and your family safe. Also, we'll have touchless entry. We'll have people at the doors. You shouldn't have to touch anything coming or going as you come to be a part of the service. And of course, we will continue to practice the same type of disciplines of hand washing and sanitization. So why do we do it? Because we want you to come here and have a safe experience at Freedom Fellowship.